Glory to God in the highest. Peace on earth, goodwill towards men. Praise God. We know what the enemy tries, he cannot win, because we know that we are in the land of the living and we serve an awesome God who is worthy, who is glorified to be praised, because he is awesome in all his ways. Praise be to his name. Thank you, Lord. At this time, we're going to look to the Lord in prayer. We're just going to open up to God our hearts, give him thanks and praise. So we all going to stand in the house of the Lord. Praise God. And for those that are online this morning, I just pray that you will tune your heart in as we worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to his name. We exalt him because he is worthy. Amen. Praise his name. Hallelujah. Praise God. We're going to pray for prayerfully saying, I will serve thee because I love thee. I will serve thee because I love thee. You have given life to me. For you found me, you have given life to me. Heartache, broken pieces, ruin lies, why you to be saved, oh God. And we pray, oh God, that we'll call upon you this morning Lord, in our situation, oh God, I pray, Father, that God, we will just cry out to you, mighty Father, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, just take full control of this service this morning. God, we leave it into your hands. Everything, oh God, that is not of you this morning, oh God, I pray in the name of Jesus that God, you will remove it, oh God, and let your spirit be with us to worship you, the Most High God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for each and everyone. Thank you, Lord, that we have gathered together to give you praise, to give you honor, and to lift up your holy name. Father, we pray for those that are on social media this morning. Lord, we just pray, oh God, those that are tuning in to listen to us worshiping you, oh God. We just pray, oh God, that they will not just listen, but God, they will worship too, mighty God, in their home. Father, thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your peace, which passes all understanding, that give us a new life to glorify your name and to honor you. Father, we just pray for the shepherd of this house, oh God. I pray, oh God Almighty, that you will give him a fresh anointing, oh God Almighty, as he continues to watch over us, oh blessed Father, to see us live holy unto you, mighty God. I pray, oh God, for each and everyone in his home, oh God Almighty, that Father God, you will continue to give them that inner peace, that God, they will continue to serve you because you are worthy to be praised. Have your way, oh God. Take full control of this service while we leave it into your hands and say, thank you. Thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Glory be unto your name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We just like to welcome each and everyone in the house of the Lord as we come to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Great are you, Lord, and great to be praised. Glory to his name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your name. At this time, we're going to read our scripture. And our scripture is taken from Revelation 13. Praise his name. He is worthy to be praised. Revelation 13 from verse 11 to the end. When we all find it, we're going to all say amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Read it thus. And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon. And he exerciseth all the power of the first beast before him, and cast the earth, and them which dwell therein, to worship the first beast whose deadly wound was healed. And he doth great wonders, so that he maketh fire came down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men, and deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he hath power to do in the sight of the beast, saying to them that dwell on the earth that they should make an image to the beast which hath the wounds by a sword and did live. And he hath power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. And he causeth all both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads. And that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark of the name of the beast, or the number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man, and his number is 666. Praise God. Glory to his name. Praise God. And we see everything that is happening in the world today. It is right here in the word of the Lord. If you just read this, you will know what's going to take place. Don't be fooled by what is going on. We know that there is come a day when all these going to fulfill. Amen. Praise God. Because God has said it, and it has been written in his word. And let us not take God for granted. Let us not just take him lightly, because what he say he will do, that's what he's going to do. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. As we honor God by his word, we say, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost. As it was in the beginning, it's now, and ever shall be, world without end. Praise God, praise God. We worship him because he first loved us and gave us his Son. We worship him in spirit and in truth. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. As we go into worship this morning, let us worship him with our whole heart, not part of us, with our whole heart this morning. Praise God. Praise God. And for all those that are in your home this morning, just worship the Lord, because he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And this morning we're going to praise him, Jesus, our blessed Savior. Praise God. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Jesus, blessed Savior, is worthy to be praised.
Praise him again.
Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Jesus, blessed Savior.
Worship him, bow down and worship.
Thank you, Jesus. He's an awesome God. He's worthy. Thank you, Lord. We magnify your name. We lift you up. You are worthy. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless His holy name. I will bless the Lord. Bless the Lord.
It's life.
Jesus is real in my soul, and he's also real in your soul. Once you call upon him, once you accept him as your Lord and Savior, he is real in your soul, because it is the only true God that can live in you for eternity. Praise be to his name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You are worthy, mighty God. Thank you, Lord. Worship him, because he is worthy to be praised. He's an awesome God. Thank you, Lord. We lift you up because we are alive and well this morning, giving you praise, honor, and glory. Thank you, Jesus. Praise his name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. We're going to change the pace a little bit, but we're still going to worship him, because he is worthy. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Awesome is your name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. He's worthy. He's awesome. And we lift him up because he's the Most High God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Anyhow. Never let your problem get you down.
Hallelujah. Thank you. and the God of love. Praise God, don't worship him.
Started. Hallelujah, that anointing began to fall. Every bit of ache and pain left. Hallelujah, that's why the tears were flowing. I'm satisfied when I look at my hands. They were new. When I look at my feet, they were too. Hallelujah, my arms are free to praise the Lord. My neck is free to bow. Hallelujah to his majesty. Glorify his name. My knees can bow before his glory. I'm satisfied with Jesus. What a God. What a healing in Jesus. Hallelujah. We come against stomach pains in the name of Jesus. Digestive pains, issues. We curse you in the name of Jesus. We break your name in the name of Jesus. Ulcers, we uproot you now and we send you back to the pit in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Every spirit of fibroids, we break your powers in the name of Jesus. Those of you who have been eating in the dreams, eating while sleeping, yes, that has caused issues, delays, burning, setback in your life, in the name of Jesus, we sever the connection. Whatever Satan is using to connect you to him, we sever it in the name of Jesus, and we command it to be flushed out now, 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 in the name of Jesus. We send the fire and the power and the healing anointing of the Holy Ghost through these airways, right where you are, right where the angels are situating themselves, and we remove it now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Yes. Hallelujah. We come against every lung infection. Yes. Every sickness, yes, in your body, we saturate your body with the blood of Jesus. We soak it with the blood of Jesus. We bathe it with the blood of Jesus. We marinate it with the blood of Jesus. Every mental issue, release it now in the name of Jesus. We destroy the strongholds in the name of Jesus. Spirit husbands, spirit wives, visitors in the night, strangers having sex with you, hallelujah, in the dream, in the name of Jesus, I serve a notice of divorcement, and we sever the connection, in the name of Jesus, we remove every spiritual ring, every spiritual gown, every spiritual crown, in the name of Jesus, every spiritual artifact that is tying you to spiritual marriages, we cut the tie in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. You sent your word. You sent your word. We send the word. We send the word. We send in the word. We send the word into you. We send the word into you. We send the word into you. In the name of Jesus. It shall not return to you. Hallelujah. We come against allergies. Allergies. Yes, I invoke the blood of Jesus into your bloodstream now. And we purge your blood. We purge your organs in the name of Jesus. And we command everything that has taken residence in your vessel to be flushed out in the name of Jesus. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, every headache, I curse you now. I command you out in the name of Jesus. Out in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of fear, intimidation, we break your powers now. In the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Come on, connect. Hallelujah. He is able. He is able. He is able. Trust him. It is done. It is done in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, word, and heal my disease.
The blood of Jesus.
Oh, yes.
You are the Lord. My healer.
You are the Lord. you that it is over. Yes, we thank you that chains are broken. We thank you that altars are dismantled. The shrines are crushed. The curse is broken. The covenant nullified. We thank you, Lord, for the blood of Jesus. We thank you for the name of Jesus. We thank you for victory. We thank you for victory. We thank you for victory in the name of Jesus. So been jealous. But in the name of Jesus, every altar that has been speaking against them, that has been frustrating them, that has been fighting over their intellect, that has been fighting over their health and their concentration, I curse you from the root in the name of Jesus. And Father, we release your war angels unto them now. And we sever and break every chain that has them bound emotionally, in the physical, in the mind, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The source over to you, Father. Whoever is fighting against the Lord, fight against the Lord. Fight against the Lord. To be like Jesus. Oh, yes. Relationships that left them so hurt that it impacted them mentally, physically. It's like they can't go any further. Some have left some relationships, and the one they left determined they would never be happy again. Yes, unless it's with them, and so they cannot move forward in anything else. But today, there is a God in heaven. I break that curse. I destroy that chain. I destroy that altar. And the blood sacrifice that was come to activate it. We invoke the blood of Jesus over it. And we render you null and void. And deactivate it in the name of Jesus. To be like Jesus. Don't waste your strength tracing somebody. Arguing with creditors and mortgage company and doctors and teachers. Sometimes you must take your strength, amen, and put it all out before God. Get the flesh out of the way. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. God be the glory.
We bless you.
Great things Hallelujah. He has done. Praise the name. Hallelujah. I feel refreshed.
Glory.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You see, I know the reason that attack came. And just like many, every time it comes to something to do with God and your soul, an attack comes. It becomes hard to go to church. You don't want to read your Bible. Come on, it's hard to pray. But if you can only press through, my God, you'll see that nothing will hold on to you. He's a deliverer. You must complete the task. My God, every day I tell you, he just blows my mind. Praise the name of Jesus. The devil don't like me and I don't like him worse. Amen. We have nothing in common. Praise God. Hallelujah. I have one upon him. What he used to do in heaven, amen. I take his place and I now worship God and sing praises unto him. So when you worship, worship in spirit and truth and just rub it in Satan's face. Hallelujah. Glory to God, and he can't do nothing. He can't do nothing. Jesus said, behold, I give you power. 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 Hallelujah. The fact that you belong to him, you already have the authority. But he says, now I give you power to trample upon demonic powers. And nothing of the powers of darkness, nothing from the underworld, no demon, no demonic seraphim, demonic seraphim, witches, warlocks, sorcerers, necromancers, shall be able to harm you. So be reckless for Christ. Act like you have no sense for Christ. Because you are guaranteed protection. What will kill others won't kill you. Hallelujah. It will just move you up higher on the ranks. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. It's good to be back in the house of the Lord. Another time. My God. Right away. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I can't wait for the church to come back together and shake this place with some praise and worship. Yes. Hallelujah. When God's people come together in one accord, one faith, one assignment, one mission. Tired of the home scene. Yes, 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 yes. Tired of the nonsense now. Hey, hey, hey. Prophets that have feet like fire, shut up in your bones. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I need a bigger place than just a home to shout my praises unto God now. Home was good when it was need something bigger now. Because a fire is shut up in my bones.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God.
Praise God.
You see when you should have praised him. Hallelujah. You are praising him. And now you're locked away. Hallelujah. And there's nobody else to praise God with you. But you better learn to push through. Press through. Exercise those muscles of praise and worship.
Hallelujah.
When you come out of that closet, the Father that sees you in secret will promote you, will openly promote you. They'll say like they said of Saul, is this the same Saul that we know, prophesying, seeing with the prophets?
Come on.
The anointing makes the difference.
Yes. Glory, glory.
Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
We bless the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah. Yes. Praise the name of Jesus.
Praise God.
Praise
God. Jesus.
Hallelujah. Let me greet you all in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Everyone in the house, amen. Clergy, officers, spouses, praise team, soundmen, camerawomen, those of you online, God bless you. Amen. Those of you on the outside of the Facebook, come in. Amen. Praise the name of Jesus. Let us know you are there. Hallelujah. Worship God in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. It's good to be in the house of the Lord. Praise God. But with the time we have left, and I really want to be respectful to the time.
Thank you,
amen. Because, you see, when you're online, it's something different. Amen. Not everybody can sit down long and look at a screen and listen to a voice over a little speaker.
That's right.
Amen. And so we want to, while we have your attention, be respectful to that.
Thank
amen.
You.
But I'm sure if you will glorify God where you are,
amen,
amen, you won't be looking at any clock. You won't be feeling sleepy or tired.
Amen.
Amen. Some of you need to just dress up like you're going to church anyways. Hallelujah. Put your phone on some big speaker. Amen. Put it on your TV. Get your tambourine and everything. Hallelujah. Shut off everything else. And it's church time. For 2 hours, God said, worship me. Hallelujah. And some find everything else to do. But when they find themselves flat on their back, they're willing to give God more than 2 hours for him to raise them up. Don't play with this God. Hallelujah. Don't play with this God. Pharaoh took Abraham's wife. Amen. Thought it was his sister. Thought he was going to have his way with her like he did with other women. And when he went to bed at night, amen, who showed up in his dream? God. And God said, if you ever touch her, I kill you. I kill you. My God. Hallelujah. And Pharaoh woke up in the middle of the night. Couldn't sleep anymore. Hallelujah. Because he realized there was a higher power than Ra. There was a higher power than all the gods and idols of Egypt. This one came into his dream, hallelujah, unannounced, without invitation, and threatened his life, and no guard could run him down. No army could seek him out. It left Pharaoh vulnerable. Because no magician, hallelujah, could conjure up anything to go against his God. Amen. Nobody saw him. Only Pharaoh experienced him. How do you lodge a complaint against God?
Tell me.
How does an army go to search and fight against God?
Thank you, Jesus.
If they can't even be successful against his children because they pursued them, and in the middle of the sea, God turned the water over onto them, and in one day, the superpower of the world, the army was no more, and that was his children. What happens when they try to come against him? The Bible says he'll sit in his heaven on his throne and laugh at the stupidity of men. Think they are something when they are nothing but dust. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let me try and cut this short. I want to minister to you from Jonah chapter 1, verse 1 to 6.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise God.
Yes, Lord.
Jonah 1, verse 1 to 6. And it reads, "Now the word of the Lord came unto Jonah, the son of Amittai, saying, Arise, and go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry against it, for their wickedness is come up before me. But Jonah rose up to flee unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord, and went down to Joppa, and he found a ship going to Tarshish. So he paid the fare thereof and went down into it to go with them unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. But the Lord sent out a great wind into the sea, and there was a mighty tempest in the sea, so that the ship was like to be broken. Then the mariners were afraid and cried every man unto his God and cast forth the wares that were in the ship into the sea to lighten it of them. But Jonah was gone down into the side of the ship, and he laid fast asleep. So the shipmaster came to him and said unto him, What meanest thou, O sleeper? Arise, call upon thy God. If so be that God will think upon us, that we perish not. Praise God, the Lord bless his word. I want to look into the wording or the phrase mentioned. Every man cried unto his God. The account of Jonah is a well-known one. Many believe it's not real, and as many believe that it is a real account. One of the fascinating things about this book is how it is written in the third person, as if Jonah never personally wanted himself to be tied to the account, except through third-person eyes, as it seems he was still troubled or hurt, amen, over what the Lord had pushed him to do, to go to Nineveh, amen, which we know was a part of the old Assyrian Empire. This book of Jonah is to the Old Testament what Acts is to the New Testament. It shows that God always had concern for the heathen who are apart from him and without hope. Amen. It also shows God's concern for his people, Israel. And you will see how that comes into play. As a result of Jonah going and completing the mission the Lord sent him on, the captivity of Israel by Assyria was postponed some 130 years. You see, the Lord may ask you to do things that you may not be, hallelujah, may not be in your comfort zone. You may not like the people he sends you to. You may not like the country, city, or village he appoints you to. You may not be a fan of the food they eat or the depth of sin they are involved in. It may be shocking to you and turn you off, amen. But your obedience will go a long way. And you may not live to see the reason why the Lord sent you and not somebody else. There may be, hallelujah, better orators than you. There may be those who know how to command attention better than you. There may be those who can sing and iron chains of bondage melt. Hallelujah. There are those that can, hallelujah, cross their T's and dot their I's, know how to sound their S's and their H's properly. But there's one thing they don't have, and it's what you have, that the Lord chose you, hallelujah, and not them. Praise God. Don't count yourself out.
Come on.
Your uniqueness is just what the Lord is looking for. That's why you're having a hard time trying to fit in. You are meant to fit in everywhere, with everyone, in everything. You're exclusively appointed and anointed for special assignments.
Come on. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Certain people just can't hang with you. Certain fashionable styles don't fit you. You can't tolerate certain atmospheres. You're specially anointed for the mission.
Yes. Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Just because it seems like you're at a standstill, don't worry about it. God will send you out at the right time for the right purpose. Hallelujah. Don't you know how armed and dangerous you are? Hallelujah. When you think hell is fighting against you to throw you off track, you're anointed and you're dangerous, but you don't know it. It's a dangerous thing, hallelujah, hallelujah, to not know how anointed you are.
Yes.
Mighty God.
Oh, Jesus.
I don't need anybody to tell me I'm anointed. My actions will speak louder than my words, hallelujah. I never have to remind myself I'm anointed. I know I'm anointed, hallelujah. Don't think my quietness, hallelujah, represents my weakness.
Come on.
I'm not in any competition to blow anybody over. I'm not in any competition to impress anybody. Hallelujah. Not because I'm quiet. It doesn't mean I'm useless. Hallelujah. Just because you're quiet, it doesn't mean you're useless. Hallelujah. Still waters run deep. Hallelujah. And it's the deep waters that are the dangerous waters. You're anointed for a purpose. Wait on the Lord and be of good courage. Sharpen your sword while you wait. Shine up your armor while you wait. Fine-tune the things that need fine-tuning while you wait, and watch God, hallelujah, when the time is right, send you out, and all hell will not be able to stand before you.
Come on, hallelujah.
You're anointed for a purpose. Special assignment. Highly classified, sharpshooter, dangerously anointed.
Yes, sir.
If you could only believe it.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
Hey, Shatana.
Give us faith to believe.
Those who believe it change worlds.
Yes.
The Bible says Philip turned over cities.
Come on.
When you know who you are and what you got. And no demon from hell can take it away from you. But like Jonah's shallow obedience, howbeit obedience nonetheless, it pushed back the captivity of Israel for 130 years. Which the captivity, when they finally went into captivity, it lasted for 70 years. It is better to obey than to sacrifice. You may not know what the sacrifice is, hallelujah, but the fact that it's a sacrifice, it means it's costly, it's valuable, hallelujah, hallelujah. It may just be you your lineage, your generation, that God is securing peace for some time in the future. So it's important to obey at all times.
Yes, sir.
God tell you to go and bless somebody with some finance. And because you see the person in a suit, you think they don't need it, not knowing that when this, you bless that person with that little money, hallelujah, hallelujah, they are at the door of their breakthrough.
That's it.
Hallelujah. And while they are standing at the door of their breakthrough, hallelujah, you're standing at the door of your financial collapse. And it may just be that same person, hallelujah, that turn around and pull you out of that pit. It is better to obey than to sacrifice. Sometimes it may cause you shame, hallelujah, unpopularity, even lose friends. But in the end, you will be the one standing tall. Who cares about friends? This road we're traveling only has room for two.
Me and Jesus.
The songwriter said we got our own thing going. We don't need anybody to tell us what it's all about. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Stop running down people for gifts. Stop running down people for anointing. Stop running down people for prophecies. Go to the master himself. Go to the gift giver himself. Go to the one who anoints, hallelujah, with fire and power.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. But like Jonah, some are trying, amen, some crazy stuff, like trying to run away from God who is everywhere. Hallelujah. How can you run away from God who is everywhere? Hallelujah. Jonah paid the ticket price, amen. And those who are running also pay their ticket price. They board the ship heading in the wrong direction, even fall asleep to try and shut out God. Hallelujah. Try and put down the conscience. I don't want to hear God that I'm going the wrong way. Hallelujah. There's a reason I'm going the wrong way, because I don't want to go your way. Hallelujah. But where can you go that God is not? David said in Psalms 139, whither shall I go from your presence, from your spirit, or whither shall I flee from your presence? If I ascend into heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the utmost parts of the sea, God, you are there, even there. Hallelujah. When I think I'm alone, shall your hand lead me, and your right hand shall behold me. Even in darkness, when I think nobody's seeing, the darkness before you is like broad daylight. Where can I hide from God? Where can you go that God can't reach you? Hallelujah. Every which way I turn to run, I buck upon God. Hallelujah. When I go to the left, I buck upon God. When I go to the right, I buck upon God. When I try to retreat back, there is God. When I go forward, there is God. How can I run from a God that is everywhere? Hallelujah. And so the Bible says that because Jonah knew God would have mercy on the people, he tried to avoid preaching repentance and ran the other way.
Come on.
Now these people, they were idol worshippers. They were savage and ruthless people. Dagon was their god. Remember Dagon when they stole the ark and they tried to put Dagon beside the ark, or the ark beside Dagon, and they came in and found his arms cut off, found his head cut off, found a mash up on the floor. And the Bible said the priest dare not go into that place until the ark was taken out. This Dagon again was their god. Some people love worshiping a losing God. Hallelujah. A losing God. All they had to do was look back in history and they would see that this God that they were worshiping had no power.
Come on.
And it's ironic that this fish god, that Or God, would use a fish to capture his prophet, amen, to go and minister to people that worship the fish god.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Yeah. It just goes to show that God isn't just the God that watches over the righteous, but also is concerned and is always reaching out to the unsaved. Matthew 5 verse 45 says God causes his sun to rise on the evil and the good and sends rain on the just and the unjust. You may not like him, but he'll still give you his breath to breathe. You may not regard him, but he'll still allow you to drink his water, live on his earth. What kind of loving God is this that sits in heaven?
Jesus.
You may curse him, but he can still convict you to worship him. He persecute his people, but watch him save you and send you around the world like a madman, like he did to Apostle Paul.
Yes, amen. That's right.
This God,
yes, same God
that we serve.
Same God.
Hallelujah. No other God like this God.
No other.
No God.
Hallelujah. Every other God, hallelujah, bows the knee to this God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glorify your name. Praise your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. This God we worship is the highest God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, there is none greater, hallelujah, than our God. One blast of his nostril, he split the Red Sea, and his presence mountains melt. Hallelujah, rivers dry up. Hallelujah, and his presence. Yet he allows us to come boldly before his throne of grace. So Jonah takes a ship to go the other way. No matter how far the other way, God knows how to bring you back the right way. And the storm began to rise and get crazy, the Bible says. The wind began to blow, and the water began splashing, and the ship begin to rock back and forth. When things don't seem right in parts of your life, amen, see who it is you have on board, who is sleeping and leeching off of your spiritual life, bringing you down. I said, when things are not going good in your life, take an inventory. Let the Holy Ghost turn on the searchlight and seek out the one that is always speaking that negative in your ears instead of faith, and is affecting you, always gossiping instead of exhorting the word of God to you, holding you back instead of pushing you forward to excel. These people, they always want a helping hand, but when it comes time for them to help, you can never find them.
Yes, come on. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Check who's on board.
Yes. Lord, overboard.
Check your passengers.
Yes, Lord.
My God. Who are you carrying while your weight is so heavy? Why the burden is so heavy? Why your sleepless nights? Hallelujah. Why every time you're shedding tears when you should be rejoicing? Who is on board?
Come on, sir.
The weather forecast before they sail, it was nice and calm sea, hallelujah, until they began to sail, hallelujah. You see, the Bible says the Lord sent, amen, the storm, which caused a panic to get the man off the ship.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Not Satan, the Lord sent to get the prophet off the ship. Stop trying to navigate the storm the Lord sends. It's to make you throw that thing or that person overboard.
Yes, come on now. Thank God. Yes, hallelujah.
These were mariners, men of the water, men who knew how to sail, how to handle themselves in the water. It wasn't their first time sailing.
Deep water, sir.
They were used to the storms and the rough sailing.
Yes, sir.
But this one, the Lord said, caused even the experienced to fret and be afraid.
Yeah.
The skill they so depended on came no use to them. Hallelujah. Because when the Lord sent, the Bible says, it looked like the ship was going to break in half. What do you do when you don't know what to do with what is going on? In the middle of a storm, in the middle of nowhere, too far to swim to shore, too far to go back, and the ship is about to break. What do you do?
Pray.
And the Bible says, every man began to cry unto their God. Hallelujah. You see, there's a time when no matter how you act nice in the presence of people, the Lord knows how to expose your heart. Hallelujah. Notice the Bible never said anything about the religion of the men on board. Hallelujah. But when the things got out of hand and they saw that their skill could not help the situation, every man began to cry unto their God and threw their belongings overboard. There's some belongings God has been waiting for you to throw overboard a long time. Hallelujah. And you refuse to come in obedience and toss it over. Well, hallelujah. God says, let me just send them in a storm their way. Hallelujah. And they start to get rid of everything, thinking this is the cause, this is the reason of why I'm going through. And you begin to throw everything overboard. Been trying to get you to throw out some things a long time.
Yes. Jesus.
Get rid of the man you're shacking up with.
Yes, come on. Hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah.
Get you out of the club.
Yes.
Speak, Lord.
My God.
Get you out of the gossip group.
Yes. Oh, Jesus. Speak, Lord. Hallelujah.
Overboard.
And a storm arises in your life. Mm-hmm. And you seek everybody else down to pray except you going before the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And, and if any of us tell them, get rid of this, mm-hmm. they kiss their teeth and walk up and say, you must be an idiot.
Yes.
Let me go someplace else.
Yes. Amen.
But there comes a time when what was valuable to you, when your life is on the line, when you're staring the end in the face, when you're looking death in the face, everything else loses its value.
Yes, sir.
And everything these men had on board, they began to throw over. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
It's good every now and then to do an inventory. And throw some things overboard.
That's right.
Go through your phone list. Go through your social media, your friends list, and those who don't add anything to your life, to your walk. Amen. Learn how to press delete. Praise God. Learn how to say no. Hallelujah. Praise God. Get them out. Learning to delete some people off of my Facebook. Because when they send friend requests and hi, how you doing? And you add them, all they want to do is send you flyers. To promote their programs.
Right.
Nothing more so.
Or ask for funds. No.
I learned to press delete. I've become an expert in pressing delete. And I'm still alive and well.
Hallelujah.
It feels so nice to walk with a clear mind.
Yes, sir.
And light feet.
Free.
Too much stuff crowding our minds.
Yes.
It's time to declutter.
That's right. That's right.
Get rid of the stuff, man.
Yes, yes, yes.
Free yourself.
Come on, come on.
Free yourself.
Come on.
Free yourself. And as some people begin to leave your life, you'll find out some habits that were hard to get rid of will also leave with them.
Yes.
That
thing you've been praying and fasting over, and it can't leave.
That's right.
As soon as you get some things out of your life, you'll watch it dissipate away.
Hallelujah.
So every man began to cry unto their God. Amen. And why was each man, crying unto their individual God?
How many different gods?
Because they have different gods.
Each man was crying unto their individual God.
My God, everybody had their own God.
Everybody had their own God. The captain revealed an answer when he went and he found Jonah fast asleep. You see, it's always the one that is with you, pushing you to go and fight. Go and do something that is out of character. Go and tell that person off. Don't let them talk to you. Go give them a piece of your mind. That one is the one that when it comes time for judgment and punishment to be handed out, they can never be found. You have to stand bearing the full blood of the judgment. Be careful who you take advice from. Be careful who you open your ears to.
Yes, 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 by your spirit, mighty God. Yes, Lord.
The captain, every man calling unto their God, went besides themselves, didn't know what to do. So the captain checked the passenger count. Amen. And when he realized there was one missing, he went searching and he found him asleep at the bottom of the ship during a storm at the bottom of the ship. He is no Jesus, but he was asleep. He's a cause of everything that is going on, but it didn't concern him. He was asleep at the bottom of the ship. I'll close with this, because I know time is gone. I remember when I was in high school, I believe it was. We were living in Quebec. My friends and I, we used to have a tennis ball and a bat. And we used to go to the side of the house. And my parents always warned us about hitting the ball, playing baseball at the side of the house, because across the street there were houses with windows and cars. But we never felt any threat, because all day we've been hitting it and it's been going over the house. So nobody really had any concern. I was up at bats again, and we had about four guys on the lawn plus a pitcher, two guys on the street in case the ball went there, and one guy behind the house in the field. So when the ball went over, you could see where it went and throw it back over. So they pitched the ball to me. And like usual, the normal thing for a guy is to show how good he is and how much strength he has, and to hit the ball over the house. I took a swing, and the ball made a beeline right through the front window of the house across the street.
Yes, sir.
When that window broke, can you believe every guy that was playing with me scattered?
Yes.
And not one could be found. And I was left standing with the bat at the side of the house. Where could I run to?
Yeah.
It was my house.
Yeah.
After being warned, I got in trouble.
That's right. Get the price.
And it's the same way in life. The one that tells you, don't mind the warnings.
Mm-hmm.
They tell you, go and tell that person a piece of your mind. Go give them a good box in the face. Who do they think they're talking to? Go teach them a lesson.
Yes.
When God is ready to deal with the matter, they can't be found anywhere around.
Oh, Jesus.
And here's the important thing. Every man cried unto their God. But it was only one God that answered.
Hallelujah. Mm. There's only one God.
Hallelujah.
Only one God answered.
God.
The times we are living in, it's getting harder and harder. Day by day.
Jesus.
And it will get worse before it gets better.
Oh, God.
It will get better, but it will get worse before it gets better.
My God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Jesus.
And the Lord allowed this to come, he says, because it will drive his people to prayer and to have faith in him.
Yes. Thank you, God.
You see, nobody wants to pray or seek him when everything is going good.
Lord.
And there I say what I'm perceiving, it will be a time when, as the Bible says, every man will cry unto their God. Just, hallelujah, to see just in case, amen, if they get an answer. And what this is going to do, it's going to reveal the heart of many. It will reveal the heart of many that are saying they are with us. Who do you turn to when things get rough and out of hand? Hallelujah. It will reveal the heart of men.
Hallelujah.
That's why it's so important to make sure you know who you serve and who you're connected to.
Mighty God.
Hallelujah. The time for masks are long over. Your faith will be manifested, must be manifested for everyone to see. All the disciples and apostles, their faith was manifested for everyone to see. Some faced boiling pots, some faced crosses, some faced a sword and saws and spears. Amen. Their faith was manifested to see if they would deny their Christ. And you're going to hear some confessions that will shock you in Christendom. Because the God who they cry unto is not the God
Jesus,
who they profess before.
Lord,
amen. Like Jonah, God is a God of second chances. That fish catching him, amen, was not to kill Jonah, amen, because Jonah repented in the belly of the fish. God knows how to bring you around.
Yes.
Oh, the God of second chances.
Amen.
If you seek him and ask mercy. But Jonah's obedience secured Israel's future for 100 and how much add years from captivity. And I pray you the same, that the God you call on when things start to get rough, seems dark and lonely, amen, will be the only true and wise living God. The God that answers, hallelujah. The God that heals and delivers and is able to turn your situation around. Praise God. Let us stand.
We bless you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Cut short for time's sake.
Thank you, mighty God.
But I don't mind. Amen. The Lord moved mightily.
Amen.
Yes, amen. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank
praise
you,
the name of Jesus.
Thank you, God.
Father, in the name of Jesus. I call Sister Armstrong before you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Who lost her son in an accident.
Yes, Jesus.
We pray the comfort of the Holy Spirit enfold her.
Yes, Lord.
And the family, Lord, as they go through this time of grief.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, be a comfort.
Be a
shoulder unto them, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. We pray for those, God, who are ill. God, we call them out of that illness. We believe that we have prayed and it is done and sealed in the name of Jesus. We refuse to believe anything less. I pray for those that are online, Lord God, that do not know you or have not firmed up their relationship with you, God. I ask that you reveal and manifest yourself to them, God. Show them their future without you. Show them how the world is winding down. Hallelujah. Time is coming to an end. Hallelujah. These unprecedented times. People are taking their life left, right, and center because they see no way out, God. Show them you are the only way. and cause it to believe on your name for salvation. Hallelujah. Lord, those that are needing work at this time, we command every closed door to open in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Those who have submitted resumes, God. Hallelujah. Done the interviews. Yes, Father, release angels, oh God. And we take those resumes and we put at the top of the list in the name of Jesus. Visit each employer, God, in the night. Hallelujah. And call out the names of your children. Hallelujah. For hiring. In the name of Jesus, those in school, God, help them, I pray. Hallelujah. Give them an intellect, oh God. Wisdom, hallelujah. Like Daniel, in Jesus' mighty name. Let them be at the head of their class and surround them with war angels to deflect every evil arrow, hallelujah, sent against them because of your favor upon their life, God. Those that have given tithes and offering and seeds, God, in the name of Jesus, stretch forth your hand, God, over them, hallelujah, and decree a blessing in the name of Jesus. Return it unto them, O God, manifolds in many ways. We pray in the name of Jesus. Never let there be lack in their life. Never let there be lack in their refrigerators and their cupboards, God. Never let there be lack, oh God, in anything they do, even their employment, God, hallelujah. It may be going under for lack of work, but because they are there and they are faithful, God, you will automatically produce work, oh God, with promotion in the name of Jesus. Bless your people one more time, God.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray.
Hallelujah.
And the people said amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. God bless you. God richly bless you. May he position you for a testimony this week. Hallelujah, that he can allow his praises to ring out of your mouth during the week. In Jesus' name, remain blessed. Praise God.